Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 4 of the Valkyria Chronicles Blind LP. So I went back to town and clicked on Castle Front Street, and this popped up, so I figured, hey, let's start the next episode. Although, you can see in the top right corner that there's my money, essentially, so I'm wondering if I have to spend it here.
Your timing's perfect. There's something I want to show you. Won't take but a minute. Come on. Ta-da! It's the writing on the wall. Written and published by yours truly. Why do this when I already have a radio news gig, you say? Sure, I could leave it up to the print news guys, but they're all lapdogs. The government censors everything. And not just a little cut here and there. In some cases, they'll bend the harsh truth into candy sweet propaganda. I'm so sick of it. I want to give my readers the truth. That includes the bad stuff, too. So, this is my brilliant plan. The writing on the wall. Some things are only possible in out-of-the-way spots like this, out of sight from those government goons. I'll keep this space filled with up-to-date, absolutely factual info. No censorship. And your exploits will feature heavily, I'm sure. So yeah, come by and have a read sometime.
Okay, spokesman. Massive anti-imperial counterstrike brewing. Just comes by all has been out of force this far. Okay, so this is just where I can see stuff.
And while you're here, I want to put a book out someday, right? To put the truth in the hands of the people. But I'm just a radio news grunt, you know? I'll be paying for everything out of my own pocket. So I figured I'd ask you. Think you could find it in your wallet's heart to help a girl get started? I'd make it worth your while. You guys could feature in the book I write. I still haven't decided what all I want to put in it, but I promise it'll be all about you. See this fat stack of notes? Got a ton of material already. So how about it? Call it an investment in the future rising star of authordom. Please.
Sure. I don't know what it does for me, but...
I plan on putting out new editions periodically, so drop by to check it out off. Especially after you've made some headlines on the battlefield. That's the perfect time to strike. I'm counting on you out there, Welkin. You need to keep me supplied with exciting material.
Yeah, so I have no idea how, like... if that helped me or whatnot. War Cemetery. No one has died, so I don't know what this is.
Paying your respects? Sorry, I suppose that was a foolish question.
Actually, no, sir. I'm not here visiting anyone in particular.
Oh, then might I ask what brings you to a place like this?
I find it sobering, standing here in front of all those who died in the last war. That, and seeing this much death, reminds me that humans are just another part of nature.
Don't suppose I've ever heard that before. Judging from your clothes, your militia.
Yes, sir. Lieutenant Welkin Gunther. I'm in charge of Squad 7, Regiment 3.
Gunther. I see. Squad leader, Very impressive for a young man.
Not at all, sir. I'm still woefully inexperienced. One wrong order from me and my squad could wind up here. It's a huge responsibility.
You respect the weight of their lives. Here, let me teach you a special order.
An order, sir? I'm sorry, who did you say you were?
Just a leftover from the last war. I'm afraid my orders require some experience, though. I can't in good faith teach them to those who lack the maturity to use them properly. Now, let's see. I'll teach you healing request today. Use it to request a medic to heal a single allied unit's wounds. Well, What is your decision?
Oh my god, I don't have enough. Well, I don't have enough.
I see. I suppose it was too soon for you.
Fuck you, man.
I hope we'll meet again. Should you wish, you can likely find me here.
Okay, so this guy teaches me orders at the cost of XP, which I don't feel like giving to him. So let's go to the R&D.
Welkin, bro! I'm stoked you're here, man! What can I do you for?
Okay, so let's develop some weapons. What's going on here? Now that I have the money, I can upgrade that. Okay.
It's done! This one's perfect, bro!
Yep. Anything in the auto voice? Body enhancements. Anti-armor shell. One. Okay. Anti-armor rounds. Reinforced body. 42,000. It's not bad. I mean, it's gonna be mostly attacking tanks, so might as well upgrade its tankness. Nothing in attack support. Reinforced body, reinforced armor. I'll get some additional armor. And reinforce that armor. Might as well try and keep the tank alive as much as possible. So rolled steel, that's not bad. Okay. Any other things? Exit.
Come back again soon, bro.
So I have done most of my money, and time to go to training. I wish I could save from in town, but you
can't. Welcome to your work.
First nightmare.
Train all you.
Got all day. So I use shock troopers quite a bit. Got 5,000. So I'm gonna level you all the way up. Level you all the way up. Level you all the way up. And see where it ends up.
You're better than the
push those limits. Yep. Cool.
Good work, mate. Looks like that session beat a new potential out of the scouts.
Okay. That's good.
Looks like that session beat.
Okay, that's good. Potential. What are yours? I've never bothered looking at them. Maternal. When any of her close friends are nearby, the desire to protect them drives all of her abilities up. Country bred, standing on bare dirt leads to a boosted concentration, racing accuracy. Undodgeable shot. Attacks have a set probability of being impossible. Okay. So, just chance that they're not going to dodge a bullet. Which is why she does seem to be a bit more, like, a bit better than other scouts. God damn. Fucking sometimes the, like, analog stick just doesn't, it just, like, weirdly goes. Okay. Melee skills, what's that? Shit. I'm dumb. I keep thinking in the mind of firing accuracy improved when an enemy is nearby. Okay. I keep thinking of the Switch controller. Okay. So, I'm gonna level you up. I could level you up to 3 as well, but I want to try and level up Scout as much as possible.
I got no.
Like, I want Scout to be my, like, go-to class.
Good work.
One, because Alicia's a Scout.
Okay, you've earned clearance for a new order.
What's this?
Put it to good use out there.
Defense boost. This order raises one ally's defense. So that's good if they're in, like, the thick of it. And,
come back any
like, you believe that they are going to get utterly demolished in terms of, So, I picked up one of the weapons from the from the So the range is lower, but it's better against people and against armor. Can I not just... Can I have two armaments on? Doesn't seem like it. And aim isn't all that good either. So I'm actually just gonna leave it. I do seem to put her into very close quarters. So maybe I'll switch it on her. I only have one of them. So seems like if it's a weapon that you pick up from an enemy, you have a limited amount. Whereas if you're, like, if I researched it, I have an unlimited. Okay, so let's return to book mode. Let's return to book mode. So I didn't do anything. No port. Personnel. Okay. So I didn't,
Report. Ellet embedded.
Okay, so that's what buying those does. That's neat. So we can watch those. And I did just find out something useful. If I hit LB and RB, I swipe the pages. That's actually very nice. So let's view this episode.
Squad 7 of Regiment 3. My first impression, good. Lieutenant Welkin Gunther, squad leader. Next in command, Sergeant Alicia Melchiot. That lieutenant looks softer than I'd expect for the son of the late General Gunther. And her. Her hometown is Brule, same as Gunther. Could be childhood friends. But if I'm lucky, they were childhood sweethearts. We'll just have to find out how close they are. Next on the list, Sergeant Largo Potter and Corporal Bridget Stark. Oh, wait, that's right. Stark had a nickname. Gotta jot that down. Goes by Rosie. There. Looks like those two don't trust Gunther much yet. That could be good. Could be really good. Who does that leave? Right, the tank pilot, Corporal Isara Gunther. She's the lieutenant's sister. Now that's strange. She looks darksen to me. Wonder how that comes into the picture. You couldn't ask for a more colorful crew than that, could you? Something tells me these guys are different than the usual troop somehow. Maybe my keen journalistic instincts? Well then. The truth's not gonna uncover itself. Here I come. Ready or not?
Gotta talk right at the camera. And to herself. So let's just go through these, and then we can get into, I don't know, more cutscenes after.
Oh, there's Sergeant Potter and Corporal Stark with him.
And this is the bridge, like where we were. You can tell because of the grass and
guys,
the uprise.
Mind if I ask a few questions? It'll only take a second.
What? Like an interview? What do you want to go interviewing us for?
Aw, come on, big guy. I bet we'd make better topics than some rich kid.
Wonderful. Let's start with you then, Largo. You fought in the First European War, right?
Yeah, I've been a soldier ever since, too. I'm what you'd call a seasoned warrior, see?
And why did you choose to stay in the force? Most people try to avoid the soldiering life.
It's an honest living, plus I got my reasons. Besides, I ain't the only one. Look at L.
L? Who's L?
If I had to guess, I'd say Eleanor Verrott. Captain Verrott, that is. 3rd Regiment. It seems you've got quite a history with her. Care to fill in some details for us?
There ain't no details. Is this the trash you want to write about? Look, I'm a busy guy. I'm out of here.
Largo, wait up!
Oh, just let him go. I
can have a little chat, just the two of us girls. So, Rosie. Can I call you Rosie? Beautiful name, by the way. Do you like flowers?
I used to sing at a bar. It was hardly a flower patch, but my nickname there stuck. Tell you what, though. Some customers came from miles away just to hear me sing.
My, my. So why is a pretty young songbird with a voice as sweet as a rose so thorny towards Lieutenant Gunther and all those others?
You just ain't trusting my back to a stinking dark hair is all.
You're an asshole.
Traumatic past experience with a Darkson leave you bitter, maybe?
Think what you want. I got better things to do than sit around gabbing about him is all. You can put me down as allergic, yeah? Just chatting and I'm starting to feel sick.
Bet she'd spill the beans if you got her riled up enough. Maybe next time. Still, a veteran carrying a torch for his captain and a Darkson-hating Chanteuse? They may be cranky, but they're characters.
They are indeed characters, and I can command them to go die. Ysara. It's a boat.
Boo!
Oh, hello, Miss Ellett. How are you?
A little freaked out now. You didn't even bat an eye at that. We're staring at the sky pretty intently. Something up there we should know about?
I'd like to fly. Well, actually, I'd like to fly my brother.
Fly your brother? Care to expound on that? You don't seem the type to have her head in the clouds. It's very romantic.
I believe myself to be quite logical, really. Too logical, perhaps.
Okay, so if you don't mind my asking, how exactly are you and your brother related? Wait, let's leave that for now. How would you describe your brother as a person?
Welks is... objectively speaking, he can seem a little strange sometimes.
I see. Although I'm a little unsure of what that means, coming from you.
But he is a very kind person, and loyal. Anytime my heritage brought me trouble, he was the first to come to my defense.
I see. Sounds like you really love him, huh?
I would say I respect him a great deal.
Gotcha. Sounds like you lucked out in the sibling department then.
Yes, very much so. That's why I'd like to give him the opportunity to fly.
I'm still not sure I follow that exactly, but we'll leave that for another day. Thanks for your time. Next up, squad leader Gunther himself.
Okay, so I guess that's just basically saying in this world, planes aren't a thing yet. But I'm guessing she's thinking, I can totally make a plane, and I will. Welkind and Alicia. I like that name, Alicia. Alicia.
Hello, hello! Are you ready for your big interview?
Yes.
Hello, Miss Ellett. Hard at work again, I see.
Didn't you already interview him before?
Oh, Alicia, I wanted to get in a chat with you today, too.
Wait, really? You're going to write an article about me?
I can't say whether it'll make the paper, but I do have some questions for you. You've been at Lieutenant Gunther's side since you left Brule. Tell me what he's like.
Wait a minute. You want to interview me about him?
Well, let's see. We only met just a few days ago, but... he's a pretty interesting person. You never know what he's going to say next. I see, I see. So, forget he's your boss for a second. What do you think of him as a guy?
What? I've never really thought about it. I don't know.
Is that so? Well, Lieutenant Gunther, care to comment in her place? Lieutenant, where'd he go?
Huh? Oh, sorry. There was just this crazy-looking bug. I got distracted.
See what I mean? He's an interesting guy, if unpredictable.
No kidding. Now, Lieutenant Gunther, I have a couple of questions for you.
First up, how do you feel about this war, as the son of a hero from the First European War?
Same as anybody else, I guess. I want it to be over. Are people looking at me as the son of a hero? Well, maybe I am, but I'm still just me.
Okay, then. Let's talk about you. What are you fighting for?
I feel like the present world is made up of things we've inherited from the past. We get life and a home from our parents, knowledge from our teachers. And not just the good stuff. Take prejudice against Darksons. That's learned behavior. Every creature out there is trying to pass things along to future generations. I want to pass on what I think is right. I'm fighting for the ability to do that.
Thank you very much. That's all I've got for you today.
Great. We're done? I want to get back to that fascinating insect again.
Huh. You really hit the nail on the head. He's as entertaining as he is unpredictable. I was planning on moving along to the next squad after interviewing everyone in Squad 7. I think I'll stick around and learn a bit more about you Sevens, if you don't mind.
Not at all. Just try to stay out of the combat zones, for your own safety.
I'm not making any promises. I go where the scoop takes me. That's just how I roll.
Like, my dream is to just see her, like, booking it, like, randomly, just booking it through an entire battlefield, just like, oh, shock troopers can't hit me, snipers can't shoot me, a tank just can't even do anything. Just running through. Yes, viewed this episode.
Squad 7's suppression of the enemy camp on the west bank gave us the foothold we needed.
Indeed.
Now we'll join the Army's Vassal Battalion in Operation Cloudburst to take back the bridge. Militia forces will take the point, crossing the bridge and attacking the eastern camp.
Captain, crossing that bridge means breaching the enemy bridgehead. What sort of on-site backup and supplies can we expect from the Army on this?
The plan calls for the Army to commence its operation after we've struck the bridgehead.
Wait a minute. So we're just being offered up on a platter?
I know how you feel. I felot that way when I was a militia foot soldier, too. But sometimes being a soldier means taking on tough missions, even dangerous ones.
Understood, Captain.
I'm not saying you're wrong, Faldio. Breaching that bridgehead by ourselves is... it's going to be tough.
Captain Verrat, may I go observe the area around the bridge?
Observe it? I don't mind, but what are you...
Welkin!
Sergeant Melkiot, what is it?
Oh, sorry to interrupt the meeting.
We're finished, it's fine. Now, I assume there's a reason for your visit?
Yes, Captain. Welkin, I mean, Lieutenant Gunther, the squad, they're at each other's throats!
What?
Please stop them, sir. I tried to, but they... I couldn't.
You want me to break it up? I don't know. Maybe it'd be better to just let them have it out.
Let them have it out? You can't just ignore them.
I'm not ignoring them. I think it's important that they say what they're thinking. Butting heads over differing opinions can be one way to bring people closer together.
Well, but... that may be, but I still... Look, you can't just sit here while your squad's tearing itself apart. It's not right. Now get a move on, sir.
Hey, I... Alicia?
Sounds like he's got his hands full.
It's all part of growing as a team.
Oh, so we got the racist bitch. And my little sister, along with the big man that probably doesn't give any fucks. So let's save after all that. Just gonna bump.
Hold on!
Okay, what's going on here?
You really have to ask, Lieutenant. It's either her or me, pal. Who let her in anyway? You really think I'm gonna work with a dark hair? She'll blow us all up. Besides, I can't stand the stink of her! Her type's got a bad reputation and everybody knows it. No Darksons allowed. You hear me?
Oh, yes. I've heard everything you have to say. But I'm still a human being, the same as you. Besides, no evidence exists to substantiate what you call the Darkson calamity. It's a myth.
Excuse me? So what, you're calling me stupid now?
Stop it, that's enough!
Okay, boss man. We won't fight alongside no Darkson. What about that, can't you understand? Another thing we ain't doing is taking orders from some hotshot greenhorn.
All right, fine. Now listen and listen good. I'll have that bridge back in Galia's hands in 48 hours.
Huh?
Now if my plan fails, which I doubt, then I'll resign. And Squad 7 will be all yours, Largo. But if my plan works, you'll take my orders and like it.
Your funeral, boss man. You sure about this?
Yes, I am.
But wait a sec. Welkin?
About sub-episodes. Some episodes listed in the book are marked with an asterisk. These are sub-episodes often telling a side story tangential to the main plot. That reason is not necessary to view them in order to advance in the game. Though there is no penalty for skipping sub-episodes, they often offer a different perspective on the events unfolding in the story you won't find elsewhere. So I can skip this. And then just go right to here. So we got two racist fucks. Oh, man. If it was my choice, I would literally just be like, okay, cool. In the plan, you guys go out and, like, try and punch that tank with no weapons. Have fun, guys. And then just be like, I'll bury you. And then just, like, you know, leave him out in a gutter or something. Because I don't give a shit. Racism is a no-go.
Welkin?
Hmm? What's up?
What's up? You just made an insane promise. That's what's up. I'm sorry, Welks. I shouldn't have argued. This is all my fault.
It's nobody's fault, East. It's a war. We're all on edge here.
I'd say it's kind of the fault of the racist fucks.
And this mission certainly isn't helping. It's little wonder the troops are upset.
Yeah?
That's why pulling this operation off is the perfect way to bring the squad together.
That'd be great if it works. But how can you possibly hope to take back the bridge in just 48 hours?
By attacking it.
Well, that's the hard part. Aha!
Huh? Aha what?
I was hoping, but there they are. Isara, Alicia, think you can do me a favor?
Sure. What is it?
You follow me?
But that's... Is that even possible?
Well, Ys, think you can make it by tomorrow?
Yes. I'll get to work on it now. All right. I'll trust you on this.
Thanks, Alicia. Well, let's get started.
Okay. So, right now we're running at 30 minutes. So, what I'm going to do is go into this. Let's go into skirmishes, do a skirmish or two. And I can't do any skirmishes until I finish the first one, so you have to go in order. I want to see. Yeah, let's fight in a skirmish battle. Let's see what happens. I only did easy because.
Here is a brief on the task at hand.
We received an intelligence report, appear activity in the area. This is your starting position. Okay, well, now we're at the top instead of the bottom. Sweep and quickly drive out the strike force back. Your objective is to occupy the base camp. Good luck. Okay. Pretty simple. Welkin dies. Enemy base camp captured. Okay. Okay, so I can have 9. So let's... God damn it. Have you... Actually, no. I want to have you up front. And... I'll put you... there. I don't know if they have a tank, so I'll just put Largo there. Put Cesare and Catherine... back. Put you there. Wendy, I'll put you... Damn it. Some of these are not very, how do you say, like, easy to tell where they're gonna be placed. And now I need Carl there. So that's the play.
Now, let's begin the operation. I'm confident victory is within reach.
Okay. So figured I would do this, so we can at least have one battle.
Let's drive these Imperials back out of Gallia! Squad 7, move out!
Just so we can have one battle per episode, hopefully. And I can start next episode on one. Okay, that's good. So, they have a Lancer, Shock Trooper, Scout, Shock Trooper. So they don't have a tank, which is nice.
Here we go!
Okay, take out that Shock Trooper. Just gonna reverse. And that action. So now I'm gonna take this sniper. As well use the scouts in a proper way. Okay, Wendy, it's time for you to be a badass.
Yeah.
Okay, take him out so they have less moves. Okay, and that action.
What is your situation?
Now!
Damn. Couldn't get rid of the Lancer. He's basically useless as of now. Oh shit, I didn't even realize. I'm gonna have her. Gonna have her run up. Because.
Don't overextend yourself. Keep the breath.
shock trooper. Okay. Catherine. Okay. Because right now the Lancer is the only one that can really do anything to the tank. Oh, get in the river.
I'm not done yet.
Enemy. And then, and that. And then I have one move left. Shock. So I could try. None of these guys are going to be able to move as far. So I'm going to move Rosie up. Scouts don't have a lot of health, so I can kill him behind cover with one of them. Okay, yeah, I'll end current phase there. Everything seems to be in pretty good standing. Of course, I am on easy, so they're not taking nearly as much damage. Or I don't know. I don't know what easy and normal do. Probably amount of damage taken / damage given. Although I wasn't able to pick like a difficulty level on the story missions, so I think what I'll do is I'll move Catherine up. I would not like to end action. I would like to stand up.
If you're hurt, use the Ragnade.
Okay. Oh, god damn it. Really, you missed? Idiot. Okay. Let's just have the tank go through. That's a shock trooper.
I'm on.
Might as well just have her bum rush.
Done yet.
Just keep up this pace.
And there is one person beyond there.
Moving out.
So let's have Alicia.
Permission to advance granted.
That's what Skaz can do. Perfect. I'd just love to see like a squad, like 9 Skaz just going in and being like, yep, we're just gonna all run up to everyone's faces, shove our gun right down their throat, and pull the trigger. Okay, so That's not bad. And it was uneasy. And it doesn't seem like I have other skirmishes available. But there are challenges. Okay. So it's like, I'm guessing you can only use certain classes. Which is pretty cool. Okay, you know what, let's try one of these, because we still got time. So might as well just show them all. Ah, okay, so Susie Evans respectfully challenge you to test a skill. Okay. Imperial squad is spread throughout the area. We will enter from this position. Please use us scouts' humble abilities to drive the Imperials out. Go this operation, defeat all Imperial units. Okay. He's defeated. The enemy occupies Gallius base camp. All soldiers and reserves killed. 20 turns pass. Oh, God. Okay. So I have a feeling. So what this does... So what this essentially means is I only get one. So I have to... And I can use reserves. Okay, just the name suggests we scouts are responsible for gathering intelligence in the field. Between our extensive mobility and keen eyes, you can rely on us to sight enemies. That being said, the area is dotted with tall grass. Do be careful not to overlook any. Hopefully we won't have any nasty surprises from Imperials in the dark. Oh dear. Thud. Oh my, I'm so sorry, I just terrified myself unconscious. Let's begin, shall we? Fantastic. Why would you challenge me to anything? So I get two moves. There's some dark grass. Here's the camp I have to defend. Well.
How many are there now? Time to do your duty, soldiers.
Way under leveled for this. I'm just gonna. Can I just quit? Damn. I don't think I saved before, or saved after the fight. Sorry. God damn it. Okay, I'm gonna retry this. Hopefully I can do it. I don't know. But I do know that I'm probably supposed to go to the bridge first. Yep. Oh, God, I'm done. Okay. I guess I'll give it one more try on camera, and then...
My turn, okay?
Okay, so I've got to turn this way.
Enemy sighted!
targeted at 10 o'clock.
Good.
All units forward.
Okay, so I'm gonna end that action. Start the next one.
Moving out.
Think I'm gonna get gonna hit that unless I get like a straight shot in. Just need to get one bullet before.
Now.
Okay, good. Got him. I need to not take as much damage as much as possible. No, I don't want to end the current action because.
What's your situation?
Okay, so that was the soldier that took my camp last time. I can retreat.
All units report in.
I'm going to at least end this, and I may retreat next turn if something bad happens. Okay. See, I like how you can't see them, but it doesn't really matter. Because, like, you can sort of tell based on where how the screen has moved. Okay, so I think I can do this. I just need to use my grenades very smartly.
Beat the smell of fresh soil.
Hostiles approaching. Try to stay sharp. Let's all get back home alive.
Be ready for an ambush, soldiers.
Enemy sighted.
Titan, all shit.
God, her fucking. She can't throw worth shit.
Firing capabilities.
Moving out.
I'm actually going to.
Can't beat the smell of fresh soil.
Oh, can I not like quit? No, I'm dumb. Okay. Okay, I think I just lost again. I wish I could skip the enemy moving turn. See, I'm wondering about the mechanic one. Like, how does that work? Okay. They're gonna win. Straight out. So. I'm gonna end the episode here. I'll see you guys in the next one. I know this is a pretty shitty way to end an episode, but I mean, at least we got a couple battles. I'm gonna retry this. I'm gonna do it until I win. So I will see you guys in the next episode. I hope you all have a very nice day.